Hi, I'm Elaine Mills with Master Gardeners of Northern Virginia, here today to talk about a group of invasive shrubs, the privets. When I speak of invasiveness, I'm using the term technically as it was defined in two executive orders. Executive Order 13112, signed by President Clinton in 1999, and 13751, signed by President Obama in 2016. Those orders state that an invasive species is one that is not native to the area in which it is found, and it can escape cultivation and cause harm either to human health, to other plants and animals, or more widely to the environment. The privets, various ligustrum species from Korea, China, and Japan, were introduced to the United States in the early to mid 1850s, and they've been used extensively for privacy hedging around residences and mass plantings along highways ever since. Unfortunately, the plants don't just stay in those cultivated areas. They produce abundant fruit, and the seeds are carried into our natural areas. There, because the plants are very shade tolerant, they can spread throughout the forest understory, suppressing the growth of native plants. They spread both by runners and by additional reseeding. Privets, which are invasive throughout the Southeast, can be controlled in a number of ways. Hand pulling is an option with the smaller seedlings. This can be done at any time of the year, although it's usually easiest when the soil is moist. There are a number of devices, such as weed wrenches, which can be used to pull out larger shrubs. These can be a little bit expensive and tend to be used most frequently by professionals to handle large infestations. But if you have access to one, you could certainly give that a try. Another option for homeowners is to cut the shrubs down close to the ground, then brush away any sawdust and paint the cut surface with an herbicide solution. You'll want to do research to determine the best chemical to use and be sure to wear protective gear and follow label instructions. You'll also want to monitor thereafter, because there could be regrowth, resprouting from the original parent plant, or reseeding from the soil bank. Luckily, there are a number of native alternatives to invasive privets, and I have three of them growing here in my own garden. The first is inkberry, Ilex glabra. This is a plant that can grow from 6 to 10 feet tall, although there are shorter cultivars, as you see here. This plant grows in sun to part shade and likes moist to wet soil. The important thing to know about inkberry is that it is dioecious. That means that there are both male and female plants. These particular ones are female plants, and they will be producing the fruit. The male plants are behind me here, and the pollen will be carried from those male flowers to the female flowers to produce that fruit. We're filming now in February, and as you can see, Ilex glabra is an evergreen plant. The other wonderful thing about it is that it's going to provide resources for our wildlife. The fruit is consumed by 15 species of birds, and the nectar from the flowers is used by multiple pollinators, including our native bees. The second native shrub I'd like to recommend is black chokeberry, Aronia melanocarpa. This grows about 3 to 6 feet tall in full sun to part shade and moist soil. The fruit will be best if the plant is grown in full sun. You'll see lovely flowers, 5-petaled white flowers with distinctive pink anthers from April to May. And this will result, after being pollinated by our pollinators, in fruit beginning in July. And that fruit is enjoyed by the birds. The leaves are very glossy. This is a member of the rose family, and the leaves look something like rose leaves. And they are used for sustenance by the caterpillar stage of our butterflies and moths. My third native replacement plant is possum haw, viburnum nudum. It grows about 5 to 12 feet tall in sun to part shade, and this particular shrub likes moist to wet soil. You'll see lovely 5-inch clusters of white flowers in April to May, and then these will result in a very attractive display of fruit. It begins with a mint green color and goes through an entire range of color changes from white to pink, then purple and blue. And at its ripe stage, it looks absolutely wonderful set against the glossy, brilliant fall foliage. This plant is a larval host for the spring azure butterfly. The flowers will attract many pollinators, and the fruit is enjoyed by our local birds. Whichever native shrub you choose to replace invasive privets, I wish you happy gardening.